Hello friends, this is Frank from Germany, and today I want to build a holder for this little micro switch for my CNC machine for the SetMax. I built this in Fusion 360, a great program, and want to print this and install this, and you can take over my shoulder. Enjoy it! Welcome back. Now we want to build this little holder in Fusion 360. And first of all, I want to show you where I need this. You see here the little micro switch on my CNC holder. And this micro switch, it's very small, and I can put this here with super glue also. I need a special holder. I want to print this out on my new 3D printer. And the first of all, we need a little sketch. I prepare this here. You see, it's a very simple sketch, but every measurement, the width and height are here noted. And mostly, this is the best way to figure out what we want to build and so on. The micro switch will come here with these little holes. We can screw this with this screw here. And yes, I think don't speak about do it. Now, first of all, we start our Fusion 360. You see, I saved a new one as switch holder. And now we need a sketch. A sketch, it's simple, it's the same that you draw this on your paper. And first of all, we start a sketch, create sketch. Then we choose a coordinating system. We use this plane, the bottom plane. Now we watch over this bottom plane. And now we can build a rectangle. The first rectangle have, I think the best way is here is the center rectangle, and we start in the middle of this point, and then we need what was my draft? We need 13 millimeter to 60 millimeter. So 60 millimeter, a little bit more. So 60, and then no, this is 13. Ah, this was so 60 and 13. So it is okay that the measurement is not correct now because it is only a sketch. So the next one is we need a second rectangle, but we use a 2-point rectangle and start here on the bottom left point and make this so, yeah, around 40 millimeters. So it's perfect. Now we need some holes, two of them to screw this micro switch on this holder here in this area. Okay, now we need a circle diameter tool. Go a little bit, zoom this a little bit, and then I guess, yeah, so 3 millimeters is okay, and here also 3 millimeters is also okay. You see, the measurements are not correct now, but it's only a sketch, and we figure out what we want to do now and so on. And I think now we are finished. Unbelievable. Okay, now that's the time we set the dimensions. You can go to sketch, and then we have here sketch dimension, or you push the button D. First of all, we want set the width of the thing, and this is 13 millimeters. That's all. Then we need the correct diameter here. Ah, yeah. No. Oh. The correct diameter is, let me think, I notice 1.7 millimeters. And also this one, 1.7 millimeters. So now it is good to have a data sheet of your micro switch. And I have here the data sheet. Let me see, here is the data sheet. Correct. So, and now you see that the holes of this micro switch has a difference of 6.5 millimeters. Then we can, I zoom a little bit. So, and then we can say this point and this point, 6.5 millimeters. And we need the difference between this point and the corner of our holder, because these two points have to be in a center of this thing here. And this is a little bit complicated, but I think, oh, okay, we have a little bit calculated this here. The half is 3.25 millimeters, 13, I think 13, 6.5. Okay, first of all, we make this here correct. So, and I think when I write, calculate, it's 3 millimeters, or? Yeah, I think it's okay. 3 millimeters, but I think it's not really correct. Now I calculate a little bit. It's, you can double-click on this measurement normally. Oh, double-click on this measurement and then 3.25 millimeters, and then it's correct in the middle, I hope. So now we need also the distance between the center of this hole and the corner, the top corner of our holder. And we can check our data sheet. Where's my data sheet? Wait a little bit. The data sheet, and now we have here the between 6.5, 1.5, 6.5 minus 1.5, it's 4 millimeters. It's not so easy. So 4 millimeters. Then we select this with this corner. No. Okay, again. This corner. The center of the hole with this. Oh, what is that here? What is it? So the distance between the center of this hole and the top corner of our holder, it's 4 millimeters. And I think now we are finished with our holder sketch. Right? Yes, and we can build a 3D object, but first of all, we say stop sketch. So now you see here, it's, yeah, a normal sketch, and now we can extrude something. How we can do this? First, create extrude, or you put the letter E on your keyboard, and then we start with the biggest part. This is this one, and this is 9 millimeter high. So 9 millimeter, great. And this one is just, no, first of all, 9 millimeters, okay. Then we have the display the sketch again, and then we choose the small part, it's this one, and make this 3 millimeters. I check here every time my sketch on my table. You see this here? And then it's not necessary to switch between the programs and so on. It looks very good. Now we need some nice corners. You can rotate this here with what do you want. You can think the middle mouse button and the shift. Then you can rotate your tool or your part, what do you want. So first I want to make, yes, a little wire channel for our switch, because when we install the switch here, then we need a little wire channel. It's also very easy. We make a new sketch, and now we choose this area here as our sketch area, and then we create also a 2-point rectangle. No, a center rectangle, I think it's better. So center, because we can now set here. Not a good idea. Verdammt, no. I need a better rectangle. Okay, then a rectangle, 2-point rectangle. So, and I think, yeah, maybe here we start here and go down. So this will be our wire channel. Now dimension here and here, and we can say, okay, this will be 1 millimeter. Yeah, I think the channel is great. And we are finished. Stop sketch. Watch this from the side, isometric. So, and now we can also say extrude. And then we go in the negative direction. And you see, we can make here a very nice wire channel. I think this is deep enough. -7 millimeters. Great. And we are finished. Now we can, you see, we have here very sharp corners. We can make these corners a little bit rounder. We use for this a modify and then chamber. Chamber, you see, makes so, yeah, chambers on edges from this part. And then you select the edges with control and check all the edges you want to add a chamber. So I think here, maybe we have to rotate this. So, okay, contour and this one. And now we say, okay, 9.4. And you see, he create all these little chambers here. Very nice. Very cool. And I think it's also good for our wire channel to build a little chamber. Then it's better for us to get this. So again, create. Now modify chamber. Zack. Zack. So also 9.4. He remember on the last setting, and it's very cool. Very cool program. So now we are finished. Save. and we want to, now we have here a normal 3D part in Fusion, but we have to convert this in our STL format for the 3D printer. It's also very easy. Take the bodies, body one, right mouse button, and then you say, let me see, save as STL. Save as STL. Now we choose the format. You can let this on binary, preview mesh, if you like, but it's not very important for us. The refinement, it's high. Please change this to high, and the refinement option, let it so. And now we can save this part as our switch holder STL. So now we are finished to build this part in Fusion 360. Now I want to show you how we can slice this in Cura. Then I upload this to the Repetier server. I have this here on Raspberry for my 3D printer. Yes, and then you see a time lapse from this 3D print. And at the end of this video, I want to install this on my CNC machine, and you can talk over my shoulder if you like. So now we have to slice our 3D print part. The STL file, here you see Cura with some setups for my ZoneStar P802N. And normally you see my print temperature is 250 degrees. I don't know why, but this is the best for me. And the bed temperature is 30 degrees. First of all, we load our 3D print STL part. I hope I can find this now. Where is it? The switch holder. Here's our switch holder, and you see it is maybe better to rotate this a little bit, because we can print this, so we can print this, so, but I think it's a little bit strange. So now you'll see here. First of all, we have to rotate this. Select, it's very easy. Here it's rotate. Sorry, it's in German, but I hope you understand everything. Rotate. And then you put this also, this program put this on a bed. Looks very nice. So now we are finished, and we can start to slice this. First of all, I have to move my cam to the other side. So you can check this also in a kind of X-ray view. And also we have the slicing here with the different levels. Now here you come, here calculate this, and you can check the filling and so on from these levels. It's a very nice program. You see also my filling, and I think my filling is 20%. Yes, 20% and three angles. I like these three angles because I don't use so much material, and it's very stable, and that's very cool. So now we save this. Now I can choose, interesting. So now I can choose ZP802, it's for my ZoneStar P802 switch holder G-code, save, and it's saved. We check, the next one is my Prusa Repetier host. We upload this G-code file. You see here I have a lot of G-code files, but I want to create a new group for this. Oh wait, I can choose my group X80C. No, I think it's better for CNC 3040. Now I can take this G-code, that's a switch holder, upload this to my server. I put here my camera on this side, maybe it's better. Now he tried to rendering everything, but doesn't care. First of all, we check our G-code. You can display this here. And for me, it's very important that I have the auto bed leveling inside. This is G32S2. And after that, we reset the extruder and try to start the printing. Also, you can see the 3D view. Now it's rendering, and the 2D view. And yeah, I think it's okay. Looks good. And we can start to print. And now for you, it's waiting the time lapse. Enjoy it. Now we are finished with printing, and you see it is close to perfect, close to. But you see this little curve here. It looks very nice because it looks like as designed. But my heating bed was too cold, and maybe you watch the time lapse video and you see this. But hey, it works. Also, I screwed the little micro switch on this holder, and now you come to my basement and we see if it works or not. So now I'm finished. I hope you like this video. Please thumbs up if you like it, and you can get this 3D model from the link in the video description. And yes, have a nice day. Bye bye, your Frank.